Namaskar, friends. Today I have a very interesting author about whom I am going to tell you. And the name of this author is Nirad C. Chaudhuri. Nirad Chandra Chaudhuri, lifespan 23rd November 1870 to 2001. So that means he lived for about 102 years. Was an English language writer of Indian origin. He authored numerous works in English and Bengali. His Avra provides a magisterial appraisal of the histories and cultures of India, especially in the context of British colonialism in the 19th and 20th centuries. Chaudhuri is best known for the autobiography of an unknown Indian, published in 1951. Over the course of his literary career, he received numerous accolades for his writing. In 1966, his work, The Continent of Circe, there are other pronunciations also for this word, but I am using Circe, was awarded the Duff Cooper Memorial Award, making Chaudhuri the first and the only Indian till date to be given this particular prize. The Sahitya Academy, India's National Academy of Letters, awarded Chaudhuri the Sahitya Academy Award for his biography on Max Müller, scholar extraordinary. In 1990, Oxford University awarded Chaudhuri, who by then had become a long time resident of the city of Oxford, an honorary degree in letters. In 1992, he was made an honorary commander of the Order of the British Empire, that is CBE. Although he was highly critical of the post-independence Congress Party establishment, Chaudhuri was more sympathetic to the right-wing Hindu nationalist movement in India. He refused to criticize the destruction of mosques. He wrote, "Muslims do not have the slightest right to complain about the desecration of one mosque in Ayodhya. From 1000 AD, every temple from Kathiawar to Bihar and from the Himalayas to the Vindhyas has been sacked and ruined. Not one temple was left standing all over northern India. They escaped destruction only where Muslim power did not gain access to them for reasons such as dense forests. Otherwise, it was a continuous spell of vandalism. No nation with any self-respect will forgive this. What happened in Ayodhya would not have happened had the Muslims acknowledged this historical argument even once." Chaudhuri was born in Kishorganj, Memon Singh, East Bengal, British India, now Bangladesh. The second of the eight children of Upendra Narayan Chaudhuri, a lawyer, and of Sushila Sundarani. His parents were liberal middle-class Hindus who belonged to the Brahmo Samaj movement. Chaudhuri was educated in Kishorganj and Kolkata, then Calcutta. For his FA, school leaving course, he attended Ripon College in Calcutta along with the famous Bengali writer Bibhuti Bhushan Bandopadhyay. Following this, he attended Scottish Church College, Calcutta, where he studied history as his undergraduate major. He graduated with honors in history and topped the University of Calcutta merit list. At Scottish Church College, Calcutta, he attended the seminars of the noted historian Professor Kalidas Nag. After graduation, he enrolled for the MA of at the University of Calcutta. However, he did not attend all his final exams and consequently was not able to complete his MA degree. From 1937 to 1941, he worked as the secretary to Sharat Chand Bose, that is Subhash Chand Bose's brother, for which, of course, there is no citation is needed. After studies, he took a position as a clerk in the accounting department of the Indian Army. At the same time, he started contributing articles to popular magazines. His first article on Bharat Chandra, a famous Bengali poet of the 18th century, appeared in the most prestigious English magazine of the time, Modern Review. Chaudhuri left his position in the accounting department shortly after and started a new career as a journalist and editor. During this period, he was a boarder in Mirzapur Street near College Square, Kolkata, living together with the writers Vibhuti Bhushan Banerjee and Dakshina Ranjan Mitra Majumdar. He was involved in the editing of the then well-known English and Bengali magazine Modern Review, Prabasi and Sony Barer Chitti. In addition, he also founded two short-lived but highly esteemed Bengali magazines, Sama Samayik and Notun Patrika. Fed up with Bengali insularity, he left Calcutta to settle down in Delhi and took up a government job there. He worked for All India Radio from 1941 to 1952, but sadly he found Delhi too was full of Philistines. In 1932, he married Amiya Dar, a well-known writer herself. The couple had three sons. In 1938, Chaudhuri obtained a job as secretary to Sarat Chandra Bose, a political leader in the freedom movement of India, as a result of which he was able to interact with political leaders such as Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, and the brother of Sarat Chandra Bose, Subhash Chandra Bose, also known as Netaji. Apart from his career as secretary, Chaudhuri continued to contribute articles in Bengali and English to newspapers and magazines. He was also appointed as a political commentator on the Kolkata branch of the All India Radio in 1941. He started working for Delhi branch of the All India Radio. He was a prolific writer even in the very last years of his life, publishing his last work at the age of 99. His wife, Amiya Chaudhuri, died in 1994 in Oxford, England. He too died in Oxford 3 months short of his 102nd birthday in 1999. He lived at 20 Lathbury Road from 1982 until his death, where a blue plaque was installed by the Oxfordshire Blue Packs Board in 2008. Student historian Dipayan Pal wrote about Nirad C. Chaudhuri in The Statesman in 2016. As to why was he always in love with England, though he had never visited the land before the age of 57. These questions, he writes, perplexed him, and the only answer he could decipher is that perhaps Nirad Chaudhuri was in search of a home that he could call his own, and perhaps this street in Oxfordshire of the 1980s took him closer to the novels of Hardy and Austen. Lovers of literature, friends, not only see texts through their lives but also sculpt life through the texts they read. His textual affinity was coupled with the colonial aura he grew up with. We must remember that he spent his first 50 years in an empire where the sun never set. His England was a realization of certain dominant sensibilities and visions he idealized. But they were far from reality. Places like 20 Lathbury Road makes me wonder why people choose to migrate and why certain places receive more sanctity than others. For Nirad Chaudhuri, England was sacred, as for some, America is. The solution to this onerous puzzle cannot be found in better living standard or socio-economic conditions of higher wages. Furthermore, certain places celebrate certain people. Nirad Chaudhuri would have been immensely happy if he knew about the blue plaque, as it would fit his sensibilities perfectly. Even Oxford County Council was happy enough to remember this, an original thinker, forthright in his opinions, and an internationalist in the sense of one who embraces the best of all cultures but never loses his own. His masterpiece, The Autobiography of an Unknown Indian, published in 1951, put him on the long list of great Indian writers. Chaudhuri had said that The Autobiography of an Unknown Indian is more of an exercise in descriptive ethology, that is, the science of animal behavior, than autobiography. The book describes Kishanganj, the country town in which he lived till he was 12, Bangram, his ancestral village, and Kalikach, his mother's village. A fourth chapter is devoted to England, which occupied a large place in his imagination. Later in the book, he talks about Kolkata, the Indian Renaissance, the beginnings of the nationalist movement, and his experience of Englishmen in India as opposed to the idyllic pictures of civilization he considered perhaps the greatest in the world. He courted controversy in the newly independent India due to dedication of this book to the British Empire. The dedication infuriated many Indian politicians and bureaucrats of the establishment. Chaudhuri was hounded out of government service, then deprived of his pension, blacklisted as a writer in India, and forced to live a life of penury. Furthermore, he had to give up his job as a political commentator in All India Radio, as the government of India promulgated a law that prohibited employees from publishing memoirs. Chaudhuri argued that his critics were not careful enough readers. The dedication was in fact actually a condemnation of the British rulers for not treating us as equals. He wrote in a 1997 special edition of Granta magazine. In 1955, the British Council and the BBC jointly made arrangements to take Chaudhuri to England for 8 weeks. He was asked to contribute lectures to the BBC and wrote 8 of these. His impressions of England and Europe were later collected in a passage to England. The Continent of Circe, published in 1965, traces Chaudhuri's doggedly independent ideas on the social, geopolitical and historical aspects of subcontinent India across the millennia. An extended sequel to his famous autobiography titled Thy Hand, Great Anarch, was published in 1988. His last book, Three Horsemen of the New Apocalypse, published in 1997, coincided with his 100th year. At the age of 57 in 1955, for the first time, Chaudhuri went abroad. After coming back, he wrote a novel, Passage to England, in the year 1959. In this novel, he talked about his visits to account of 5 weeks in England, 2 weeks in Paris, and 1 week in Rome. Chaudhuri was deeply distressed by what he saw as the deep hypocrisy in Bengali social life, and in particular, those that resulted from class and caste distinctions. His historical research revealed to him that the rigid Victorianesque morality of middle-class Bengali women was a socially enforced construct that had less to do with religion, choice and judgment, but more to do with the upbringing, social acceptance and intergenerational transference of values. His prose was highly influenced by Sanskrit and the older version of the Bengali language, the Shadhu Bhasha. He had little respect for proletarian language, that is, Cholti Bhasha, which he regarded as being common in taste and scope. He avoided the use of words and very common expressions originating from Arabic, Urdu and Persian in modern Bengali. And so friends, that is Nirad C. Chaudhuri. I felt he was almost forgotten. That is why I brought him to you. And of course, he was awarded D.Litt from Oxford in 1990 and Sahitya Academy Award in 1975. So that's all I have for today, friends. Goodbye and see you soon.